An airplane is flying from San Francisco, California to Denver, Colorado. As it begins to descend, the altitude of the plane is given by the equation A equals 33,000 minus 120 t, where A is the altitude in feet and t is the time in seconds. We want to answer the following questions. Number one, what is the slope of the line and what does it represent? Remember, if a line is written in slope-intercept form or the form y equals mx plus b, the coefficient of x would be the slope. So if we wanted our linear equation to fit this form exactly, we could write this as a equals, we'll put the x term first, so it'll be negative 120 t and then plus 33,000. So in this form, we should be able to recognize that the slope is equal to negative 120. If we want to make meaning of the slope, it's helpful to put it over 1. And normally, slope is the ratio of the change of y to the change of x. But in this case, the change of y is actually the change in the altitude. And the change of x is actually the change of t. So the slope tells us the plane's altitude is decreasing at 120 feet per 1 second. And we know it's descending because the change in the altitude is negative. So let's go ahead and write this out. The slope represents the rate at which the plane is descending, which is 120 feet per second. Number two, what is the y-intercept and what does it represent? Well, the y-intercept is the value of b, so the y-intercept equals 33,000. Remember, the y-intercept occurs when x is equal to 0, or in this case, when t is equal to 0. Well, at t equals 0, that's at the instant the plane starts to descend. So t equals 0 represents the height of the plane right before it begins to descend. So the y-intercept is 33,000, and this should be in feet, which represents the altitude of the plane right before it descends. Number three asks, what is the altitude after 3 minutes? Well, again, we're given the equation that tells us the altitude when t is time in seconds. So the one thing we have to be careful about here is that the time is given in minutes, but the equation requires time in seconds. So we first need to convert 3 minutes to seconds. And since there are 60 seconds in 1 minute, we can see here that we're going to use t equals 180 seconds. So we'll have the altitude is going to be equal to, we'll go ahead and use the original equation, 33,000 minus 120 times 180. So we'll have 33,000 minus this product, which is 21,600. And this difference is 11,400. This would be in feet. So after 3 minutes, the altitude of the plane is 11,400 feet. And then for number four, once the plane starts to descend, how long will it take to land? Well, going back to our equation, A represents the altitude of the plane. So right when the plane lands, the altitude would be 0. So if we set A equal to 0 and solve for t, we can answer number four. So we'll add 120 t to both sides. So we have 120 t equals 33,000. Let's go ahead and finish it over here. So we'll divide both sides by 120. So we'll have t equals this quotient, and 33,000 divided by 120 is equal to 275. And this would be seconds. If we want to convert this to minutes, since there are 60 seconds in every minute, and 60 times 4 is 240, this would be equal to 4 minutes and 35 seconds. Again, 6 times 4 would be 240 seconds, leaving us with an extra 35 seconds. I hope you found this helpful.